Marauders, welcome back to the channel. I'm not going to do an in-depth review of this machine, but I had a T76, a Bobcat T76 as a loaner I used over the weekend. And impressive machine, very strong. I think it's a little too big for me. Boy, I see a lot of feathers. Feathers flying. They're making noise this morning. Are they fighting over territory? They roost on the houses at night. I don't mind them as long as they stay off my patio. Anyways, quick look at the Bobcat T76. As you know, I'm thoroughly impressed with the E42R2 excavator. This does have the wide track, bar tracks, which I would get. These are 17 inches wide. Does not rut up the lawn. It really does float. It does scuff a little bit. If you turn tight or you're not on a level piece of ground, it will scuff. But you know what? My tractor ruts. This is the issue I'm facing. If you can see that, those are ruts from my tractor turning. That does do a nice job of taking excavator ruts and smashing them down, smoothing them over. Bucket is great for grading. Basically what I used it for over this weekend was I cast with the excavator, digging holes for the trees and put it in the bucket. It worked out well. A very industrial machine compared to a tractor. Seat height, close. I think you're sitting, that was one of my concerns, snow blowing, that in the tractor you're sitting up so much higher. I bet you there's a difference of maybe 8 inches in seat height. Visibility is far better in a tractor than it is in a track loader, but this with a camera in the back I think would be sufficient. All right, let's start it up, take it around the property. This takes a little bit of getting used to. I don't have to put a seat belt on or a bar, drop a bar in front of me on the tractor. Hit the go button, let the glow plugs warm up a little bit. And this unlocks everything. So now the joysticks are active. This does not have the rear view camera, I wish it did. Not comfort space, not bad in the machine, frankly. Air conditioning is at a good location. The stereo would be up here along with the rear view camera. Does come with self-leveling bucket. Raises the bucket over here, this joystick. And then this is your drive. Engine is quiet. Couple things about Bobcat. Other manufacturers note this. It does not take DEF, diesel exhaust fluid. It does not need that, and it doesn't go through regen. That's really good. That's really good. All right, let's take it for a drive. I'm gonna add some RPM. Not go crazy with it. And steer with my left hand. I'm gonna add some more RPM. About 1700, well, 2000. Bobcats are relatively quiet. I left their engine running for about an hour or two and went to bed and forgot about it. Had to go back out. Didn't leave it running the entire night. But they are amazingly quiet. And I'm going to take it around the perimeter of my property. And as you can see coming up here, there's some ruts the track excavator left. And I bet you this thing will just smash them out. This area, I've been a stone. I'm tired of working in the mud. up and look at this. And you know what it does? I don't know if you can see it, but it does just flatten out the areas. I'm gonna level this area real quick. I don't know if you can see it on camera. But this is an area where I park my machines. Let's see how fast it levels this out. I think it's gonna do it very fast. Boy, they are grading wizards. That's dried and packed, but look at how nice that cleaned that up. Tractor could not do that. Maybe even not with a box scraper, you'd have to work it a lot longer, but this did it very quickly. Had 3 days of dry weather, love it, and I can finally get out and work my property. And this has to be mowed this weekend. We're in for a 7-day dry spell, and we're gonna work on this property. I don't think the noise is bad. I'm at 2000 RPM, a little over, and I don't think the noise is bad in this machine. It's very acceptable, but we'll see when I edit the video. Ranger left some tracks. I don't know if you can see that. That tree's gonna come down. I'll put it in rabbit mode. I think they hit that button. Where I rolled out some excavator tracks where I got stuck. into this topsoil pile and see how it does. This pile. Oh my god. Oh my god. I could not do that. I could not do this with my tractor. Wow, guys. I could not do that. That was pretty amazing. Wow. I don't even think my JCB backhoe would do that. Wow. Wow, this topsoil's been here for 20 years. Pretty amazing. I'm kind of pleasantly surprised. And they say this T76 is like a bulldozer compared to another great machine. Wow, very impressed. I'm surprised on the rental unit they don't have a camera for safety, although it adds a lot of money to go to that option. And again, the tracks were spinning. If it was dry, wow, that was pretty amazing. That was an old compacted chunk of topsoil. Okay, let's load around the trailer. Not crossing the creek. The tracks are loose on this machine. So I really don't want to a creek or do something muddy, and I want to return it today. Let's see how it is going over the curb. Does a better job crossing curbs. So it's interesting. The RPMs go up to 2590. I was running it at 3/4 throttle, and I think people, they want you to run it at full throttle. Okay, so this is not easy, because it just fits on this trailer. I'll give you a view of loading it on the trailer. Thank you. what she looks like loaded. I've had incidents where I've had light tongue weight on a trailer that has not been fun. This is probably loaded a little too far forward. Hope you'd like the I hope you like the quick tour of the Bobcat T76 track loader. Please consider liking, subscribing, sharing this video, and have a great day. God bless. Let's respect each other. Hope to see you on the trail. Property's looking better. Two tree on either side of that one, another one there. Planted 12.